Hei, sapi udah tadi.
Udah di-announce.
Hah? Sumpah, udah di-announce. Udah di-announce. God damn, sir.
Welcome to Hong Di, my guy.
Gua mau baca dulu. Gua mau baca beritanya dulu nih. Gua baru buka HP nih. Gua benar-benar baru buka HP nih, chat. Kalau mau yang lucu-lucu ada Kidilan Jen di situ, udah lihat gua. Di lantai 2 kan. Dia mau ngerokok cuma buset. Gila banget anjing. Berarti Boom bakal ketemu SPG lagi ya, anjing lucu banget tuh kalau kejadian. Baca dulu. Riot Games removes Bleed Esports from Fishery Pacific and promotes Boom Esports. What the dog doing? After careful consideration, Riot Games has made the decision to remove Bleed from the Valorant Champions Tour and Fishery Pacific. Bleed Esports was terminated due to its failure to comply with critical. God damn. Ya kan? God damn, bro. Shit. They fucked up and they fucked up bad, bro.
Chat. Chat, no more fucking nightmare, chat. This is real, chat. Come on, chat. This is real, chat. Gila, men. Baru kemarin bilang, kenapa nggak 2 slot aja ya? Bisa nggak sih? Padahal tuh kan kepikiran tahun depan tuh mungkin banget 2 slot gitu. Karena ada possibility tim Ascension-nya emang kayak gagal untuk memenuhi kayak minimal si playoff itu. Atau mungkin champion kan. Kejadian coy tahun ini coy. Unreal bro, bisa 2 slot, real chat, real, gelo chat, buset, wah dikasih membership, welcome Boom, to Pacific, congrats. Thank you juga membershipnya dari Racy 20. This is not the end untuk Boom. Mereka dapat rezeki. Mereka harus melanjutkan dan seenggaknya. Rizky gak main OMTV. Latihan Lucky anjing. Tapi ya, satu sisi ya. Kita harus melihat juga ini apa permasalahan dari Bit. Tapi bodo amat, yang penting Boom masuk. Tapi tetap, kayaknya di sini adalah gagal untuk kasih report, ya kan? Report yang critical requirement nih, requirement buat team participation agreement. Jadi ini mereka nggak boleh rakus intinya. You know, seperti yang apa ya contohnya? Bola kali ya? Yang kayak mau rombak total gitu kayak sih? Ya gak sih? Mungkin kayak gitu. Karena mungkin kelamaan buat nyari tim. Ya gitu mungkin ya. Bleed gak bisa ikut lagi. Protect best interest of player sama league. Kayak NBA ini ada salary cap-nya, mungkin itu juga karena terlalu over mungkin. Pasti. Pasti. Iya, soalnya di balik layar juga pasti ada kayak soal laporan keuangan, duit lu abisnya kemana aja, pemainnya siapa aja. Jadi mungkin faktornya banyak juga ya yang kita nggak tahu juga yang membuat si Blit ini rungkat dan Boom Esports masuk ke VCT Pacific, adik-adik. Tidak ada Robert lagi, chat. Robert sekarang kerja, udah nggak jualan kursi gaming Secret Lab. Kerja beneran, chat. He will back. Kita bakal dukung Robert. Robert, berserse. Gelo, chat. Blit posting prop. Blit, what just happened with Blit? This morning, kita diinformasikan oleh Riot Decision untuk terminate tim kita. Dan remove dari VCT Pacific. Kita sangat kecewa dengan hasil ini. Tapi kita respect keputusan Riot dan akan melanjutkan proses. Tahun lalu kita udah komunikasiin dengan Riot terhadap isu ini related berhubungan dengan TPA, Team Participation Agreement. Oke. Okay. Sayangnya kita nggak bisa rectify apa ya? Rectify apa ya? Kita nggak bisa ngedeliver, kita nggak bisa ngasih isu ini dengan sikap yang memuaskan. Dan keputusannya ya ini, ngeterminate partisipasi kita di VCT Pacific. Segenap kru yang bertugas, kita bakal evaluasi posisi, title. Di lain sisi, kita akan tetap melanjutkan Valorant. Artinya ada Blit dong tahun depan, Ascension. Kita akan melanjutkan Valorant player dan... Artinya ada... Artinya ada Blit dong tahun depan. Tahun depan ada Blit, chat. Kayak gitu, coy. Gak sebanding sama hasilnya, iya itu. Karena terlihat gitu, guys. Selesai season lu langsung ganti. Bahkan di tengah-tengah langsung ganti. Mereka tuh pengen langsung hasil instan. Gitu. Tapi permasalahannya bukan di situnya. Sebenarnya tuh niatnya tuh bagus. Kenapa? Karena sebagai tim Ascension, lu kan punya waktu nggak banyak, 2 tahun. Dan lu harus dapetin hasil yang paling maksimal. Tentu lu mau ambil pemain yang paling terbaik gitu. Tapi ini pasti ada masalahnya di belakang itu. Jadi ya. Bumpy masuk!
Dan harus ada waktu untuk nge-defuse di posisi seperti ini.
Bang Ren, lu minggu main di tim LVG ya? Iya. Sob, Little Famosin. Gelo. Gue udah immortal. Jumat ini tuh bahagia banget. Gue immortal. Boom Esports lolos. Iya, Boom Esports masuk ke franchise. Terus gue masuk ke top 4 Predator. Anjay, mantap banget. Nanti kita ketemu lagi, anjay. Blit ada problem apa? Katanya sih ada apa ya? Kalian bisa baca sendirilah, banyak pokoknya.
Nah, Riot Games removed Bleed Esports from PCT Pacific and promotes Bloom Esports. After careful consideration, Riot Games has made the decision to remove Bleed Esports from the Valorant Champions Tour and PCT Pacific. Bleed Esports was terminated due to its failure to comply with critical reporting requirements and other key obligations under the team participation agreement. Removal of a team from the Riot Games esports ecosystem is not something we take lightly. Euphoria. Sebenernya gue udah tahu, cuma gue gak nyangka bakal dia dance secepat ini aja. However, due to persistent operational failures. Bleed Esports will no longer participate in VCT Pacific to protect the best interests of the players and the league. The individual players affected were informed of the decision as soon as it made.
Also, just to clarify, I was meaning to stream today anyway, so... But what I was planning on doing was just chilling, playing some Deadlock, maybe playing some Zenless Zone Zero, I don't know, just like talking about stuff. Talking about the Plat chat a little bit before, you know, like, I wasn't planning on any of this. And then freaking this happens, and I have to wolf my lunch down and get online. But yeah, okay, so for anyone who missed it, which I don't know, hopefully none of you missed it, because already 500,000 people have interacted with this tweet. But Bleed Esports was terminated due to its failure to comply with critical reporting requirements and other key obligations under the TPA, the Team Participation Agreement. So, This is the agreement that every team has to sign, and this is kind of like the, you know, what you have to pass to join VCT, right? This is what all the original teams had to sign, and obviously when you go through Ascension, they have that whole check with the Ascended orgs, and you have to sign this. And this is, I'm sure this involves all sorts of things, right? You have to report on your finances and what you're able to do, and you know how much it's like getting a loan or getting a house or whatever it is, any type of business agreement where you have to prove that, like, hey, I have the income source, this is what it looks like, and then you also have to agree that we're gonna, I mean, it sounds like other key obligations could mean anything ranging from, you know, whether it's simply just following some rules all the way to, like, teams have a set number of videos they need to make about a set number of topics throughout the year. Like, this is why you see, like, for instance, like RRQ puts out a video every time for champs, right? Even though they didn't make it, where it's like they're just promoting champions. Like, every team has that. Like, you have a set of content and things you need to do. So it could be part of that. Like, I mean, this is obviously, it's very vague for obvious reasons. But anyway, apparently didn't meet a number of them because they don't take this lightly. And Riot says, however, due to persistent operational failures of the team, Bleed Esports will no longer participate in VCT Pacific to protect the best interest of the players and the league. Now, okay, so this is the part we want to kind of give it into, because it says the individual players affected were informed of the decision as soon as it was made to allow them to explore other opportunities as quickly as possible. Soon after that, oh, that's not what we wanted to click on. Soon after that, Legia, the coach of Bleed, says, well, jobless overnight heard 30 minutes ago. So, supposedly, the decision was made 30 minutes ago, and then they were let, you know, they let everyone know before the official tweet went out 30 minutes ago. So, who knows what happened there? And then this is Bleed's announcement. This morning, we were informed of Riot's decision. I assume they mean this morning as in, like, within the past 6 hours, because we're in Asia. We are informed of Riot's decision to terminate our team participation agreement and to remove us. We are deeply disappointed by this outcome, but we respect Riot's decision and will continue to cooperate with them throughout this process. We have been in constant communication to address issues related to our deliverables in the TPA. Unfortunately, we were unable to rectify these issues in a satisfactory manner, and the decision was made to terminate. We will continue to support our Valorant players and staff during this situation, as we do remain eligible for challengers. Okay, so they're not, like, completely banned from everything, right? So the facts that we know are that they are not completely banned. They are removed from VCT, which, by the way, this is a good reminder on this is how VCT works, right? Tier 1 works. It's not like franchising. You're not buying your slot in, but it's a business agreement, right? I know a lot of people are still... People are... By the way, if you're still hung up about, like, Optic should have made it, I mean, get over it. Like, it's been a while. Anyway, and multiple team owners have talked about whether they messed it up or they think, you know, they misunderstood whatever it was. So, but it's a good reminder that this is a... It's a business partnership. And so, obviously, things like this can happen. But yeah, so it, I mean, honestly, everything seems to line up with, I mean, it, listen, I'm not trying, listen, I don't think we should witch hunt Riot. I don't think they're lying here. I think they were informed as soon as possible. So I think basically what they're trying to say is, it's not like we made this decision and then we hid it from everyone until like suddenly now. They're just saying, hey, we made a decision and we let them know as soon as possible. Riot's PR is very, very actually very, very PR. It's very, very crafted, so I don't think they're lying or anything, so I don't think anyone should go on that witch hunt, but it could be true that the decision was made this morning, or like late last night, right? And then they let them know this morning, and then the tweet went out, so, so like, you know, I mean, listen, let's not read into that too much, but it does sound like they were, all the team was notified, like, earlier today, so... So yeah, that's pretty, yeah. I mean, listen, we can speculate all we want about like, oh, like, I wonder if it's because of like where the money comes from, or do they even have enough money? You know, is it even true? We can talk all we want about that. I don't, unless someone wants to do like actual investigative, you know, research and journalism, I don't think we're really gonna know, and obviously even then you'll probably need some sort of a confession out of somebody. But all I'm gonna say is this, I will say there is a decent likelihood that there's probably additional stuff outside. Like, it's probably a combination of like business related things, and then also I would imagine like content related things. So there is that. And then yeah, then there's this. Who? Why is this logo a friggin' Discord logo? According to a former lead employee, there were instances where players were delaying payment for a couple of months. I mean, listen, this is a report, so, you know, take it as you will. But again, I mean, we're all working off of reports, so that's probably a combination of that. I imagine, because I'm trying to think at the top of my head. I'm trying to think if I actually remember any Bleed Esports videos other than comms videos. And I wonder if there's something there as well. Right? So... I mean, that's CS. You have comms videos. I guess you have this. This is a bit of a vlog.
Anak ngentot, lu ketemu lagi sama gua, mati lu anjing. Lu ketemu gua sama gua lagi, mati lu anjing, sumpah.